Welcome to Legend of Kyrandia. Okay, so this is the guy over here. This is Kallak. Okay, the guy that you saw jumping through the window, that was Malcolm. Malcolm's crazy and not really happy with life, and he controls all the sources of the power in this game now. And the thing that he's holding is called the Kyra Gem. This is a Westwood Studios game. They didn't make a lot of these. They made three of these games. In fact, they made Legend of Kyrandia 1, 2, and 3. I don't know if we're going to play all three of them, but we're going to certainly play the first one. This is very different from what we used to. For one thing, there's a big old options thing here, and we've got load, save, game controls, and quit playing. Music is on, sounds are on, walk speed is normal, text speed is normal. There is a CD-ROM version for this version of, for this game. I'm not playing that. This is the regular old DOS disk version. Again, so I can do voices and so that we can get things done. So that what happened here was that Malcolm was trapped and he got free somehow, we don't know how, and he's now kind of wreaking havoc on the land. The way this game works is there is only one cursor and everything is controlled through the one cursor. Westwood tried to sell this game to Sierra because they thought this whole thing of the single cursor was a great idea. But at the time, I think it was King's Quest V, Sierra were kind of embroiled, or no, at this point it might have been 6. Sierra kind of embroiled in making King's Quest 6, and they looked at this and looked at King's Quest 6, and they were like, eh, no. So Westwood kind of made it by themselves. So how this works is, if you click on something like this, it's obvious it's an object, and it's not part of the scenery, it will go, it will tell you what it is, it's a garnet, and you can put it in your inventory. Now, unlike Sierra games, there are only these slots here. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 10. You can only carry 10 things. There's a thing going on here, which we're going to see later. But anyway, you can only carry 10 things. So we can pick up the note. If you want to read the note, you click on new. Blank, except there's Bryn's name on it. I'd better go to the temple. Bryn will know what to do. I'm going to just tell you now that Brandon's not the most likable character. He's not likable. He's just, like, incredibly, incredibly bland. This is Kallak. Kallak and Brandon are not actually related, but he treats him as his grandfather. Grandfather, can you hear me? No. He cannot, I'm afraid. You can't get anything over there, but we'll go and click on it anyway. Rocks. And an apple. Okay. Should I lay Grandfather on the bed? I don't think he can carry him. I don't think there's any way to move him. And then there's books over here. The Mystic Book Club. Nice covers, but lousy reading. Okay. The only other thing that's going on here is this thing there. And I don't... Well, I have to do everything. I think I need to leave and then you'll wake up. Yes. Brandon. What? Who said that? Are you Brandon, grandson of Kallak? I am. What are you? We are the other kingdom, Brandon. We speak for the land. Why would the land speak to me? We are dying, Brandon. Magic spells of an evil intent have upset the balance of nature. Well, don't you have magic? After all, you are a talking tree. Can't you use your power to fight this evil? Evil exists only in the kingdom of man, Brandon. The land has no evil, and thus no defense against it. But the magic kyrogem, symbol of the pact between our kingdom, has been corrupted. Now it can no longer protect us. You, Brandon, must oppose on our behalf. What? Why me? You have been chosen, Brandon. Your destiny was forged before your birth. But I wouldn't know where to start. Let your faith guide you, Brandon. Prepare for your journey. And he sinks back into the tree. Wait, what happened to my grandfather? Okay, so he's not quite as helpful as Cedric. He doesn't actually tell you what happened to your grandfather. It's quite obvious. So anyway, we're gonna leave. My old sandbox makes a great planter. Nice big sign. But I guess we should have used the boards to make it the front door. Well, not really. Kyrandia is not actually. I'll leave this on. I don't suppose the Lost will annoy him now. The land of Kyrandia, or the land of Kyrandia is not really dangerous. Not in this installment of the game, anyway. So this is below brand time. You will see every time you go to a new place, this is kind of like a text adventure thing, it will tell you where you are. So in typical old adventure style, the thing that you do here is you're gonna walk around a lot. Also, the soundtrack is amazing, by the way. The game has flaws, I'm gonna just tell you now, the game does have flaws, but the soundtrack is not one of them. I bet I can catch a teardrop. Brandon's so goofy, but so bland. Okay, you got a teardrop, good. Right, so, we're gonna continue our walk. I have not played this game since 1993, so I am a bit rusty. The falling leaf here is a sign of the land dying. Something strange is happening here. Anyways, we need to pick that up. Peridot placed, and we need to pick that up to the amethyst. All these gems are going to become useful, but they're not useful now. But we do need them. So, I haven't played this game in a long, long time. The last time I did play it, like seriously play it, I played it with a buddy of mine in 1993, more or less, when it came out. And it was a great vacation game. We both kind of got sick together and hung out and played this game. So, I mean, we were puffing and it wasn't very pleasant, but this was a fun diversion. This is Herman. It wasn't my fault. So to talk to people, what you do is you generally click on them and that will do that for you. I didn't say it was your fault, Herman. Huh? Aren't you going to fix it? Sure, but I don't know how. I meant to replace the bad planks, you know, but you know how time flies by. I hope nobody important tried to cross. I could lose my job. Can't you just get some new planks and rope? The rope's okay. I just need new planks. You expect me to cut planks with my knife? Yes. I'll see what I can do. Okay, so one other thing about Kyrandia, as opposed to other adventure games, it's not really obtuse about what you need to do. It's obvious that for Herman to do what he needs to do, he's probably going to need to saw down some wood. So we're going to have to find him a saw. I seem to recall that the saw is lying on the floor somewhere, but I don't remember where. So we'll just wander around some more. That's basically how the beginning of this game goes. You walk around a lot and solve small problems. And then their mazes. Oh god, let's not even talk about the mazes. I'm already shuddering thinking about them. To the best of my recollection, there are two. One I remember quite vividly, another one I don't remember at all, but we'll see when we get there. The great stump. A rotting tree. What happened? This one looks half dead. Okay, so, see there's a funny tear-shaped thing in there? You grab this, and you stick that there, and you heal the land. Hey, the teardrop fits. Wow. I healed the willow tree. That was amazing, Brandon. Wanna play? I'll show you this marble I found. Sorry, I can't play it now, Merith. But let me see that marble. Oh god, Merith, if you want it, you'll have to catch me first. I don't know if we're gonna be able to catch Merith, but we'll try. Look at Brandon. I'm going to walk. This is the kind of thing I mean. Can't you move any faster? I'm not chasing you, Merith. Right. He's walking behind him. Over here, Slowpoke. I'm not chasing you! Okay, let's carry on going. We do kind of want the marble. You're following pretty close for someone who's not chasing me. I am gonna have to remember to find a map for this game. Not that it's like difficult, but we're still gonna have to get one. Okay, so now there's no sign of Merith, so let's try going up. Thought I'd sneak around the other way, huh? This is kind of genuinely mean. Oh, Merith. Let go of the branch, Merith. Ah, bad advice. I'll catch you. Oh, bad advice. Very funny, Brandon. You can have the marble. I'm not playing with you anymore. Okay, and Merith goes away and we have access to marble. Thanks, Merith. Okay, the marble is taken. We wanted to go to the left a little bit because I wanted to have a look around. This is, again, you know, it's The design of it is kind of sort of 80s, late early 90s, where the first bit is kind of like a treasure hunt, so there's a lot of stuff that isn't nailed down and you just kind of have to pick it up. Yes, yes, Binance House. We keep getting sidetracked by other things. Now notice it's a thriving tree. This is quite beautiful and restful. There's like a beach down there and you can wander on up this way. And hey, this is story, so what I think we're gonna do, I'm gonna call it a episode here because we've got less than a minute left. And next week we'll go into the temple because there's a lot of story going on in here. This is where you remember he was talking about when you clicked on the note. It said it has Brendan's name on it. This is where Brendan lives. So next week what we'll do is we'll walk on in and we'll go and talk to Brendan and maybe she'll have something useful to tell us. I hope you enjoy Legend of Kyrandia. Again, I wanted to play something that's not quite so dark. This is not a funny, funny game, but it's not Limbo, and it's not The Dig. So, hopefully you guys enjoy that. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, lostwolfe. I'll see you next week when we play more Legend of Kyrandia. Until then, have a great week, folks, and goodbye.